This is the legend of the Kandahar giant and his encounter with U.S. Special Forces. It was 2002 in Kandahar during the war in Afghanistan when a U.S. Special Forces unit that specialized in rescue missions was called to duty. Their mission? To find a unit that seemed to have just vanished deep within the mountains. They wasted no time and began moving as they wanted to be back before nightfall. According to an eyewitness that was part of the Special Forces unit, they had trekked 4 miles up the side of the mountain, and they were almost to the last pinpointed location of the lost unit when they began finding broken military equipment strewn about all throughout the mountains. That's when they looked up and noticed a massive cave. As they approached the cave, they noticed a rancid smell and began seeing body parts laying all over the ground. When all of a sudden, an 18-foot-tall giant flew out of the cave, spearing one of their men. Stunned, the unit immediately opens fire, letting them have it. Part 2. Alright y'all, I apologize for the wait. This is the legend of the Kandahar giant, part 2. He was a monster, the witness explained. You could see in your peripherals the bodies stacked up at the cave entrance. This led us to believe he was a cannibal. With a red beard and scarlet red long hair covering his shoulders, and Dan, whose body lay limp at the end of his spear. As I noticed he had 6 fingers and toes, the lieutenant yells fire, snapping me back to reality. We began shooting the beast, quickly noticing the bullets were having little effect. The beast tosses Dan 30 feet off the end of the spear, as if nothing but a toy. He moved so swiftly, you would never believe he was actually as big as he was. Wielding his spear, he began barreling towards us with bloodthirsty rage on his face. And as if instinct kicked in all at once, we all yelled out, "Aim for the head!" The team was carrying an M4 submachine gun, a 308 sniper rifle, and a Barrett 50 caliber. Within seconds, he fell to the ground lifeless. And the team remembers the day they battled the Kandahar Giant, Part 3. Legend of the Kandahar Giant, Part 3. So as the giant lay there dead, they radio back to base, and a chopper comes and picks it up. It weighed in about 1,200 pounds. This beast had a total of 12 fingers and 12 toes. And by witness account, it smelled like it hadn't bathed in probably 10 years. Nasty. And of course, standard procedure as they got back to the base, they made him sign a hush-hush agreement, stating that the world wasn't ready for this info. The witness who shared this story felt that the people should know, and that there was no reason to keep us in the dark. At the end of the day, I know this is hard for some of you to believe, but giants have been in our history since the Bible, the biblical days. The Nephilim are fallen angels that came down and bred with humans. This enhanced our race. That being said, I ain't telling you gotta believe shit. Believe what you want. And one guy promised he was 22 feet as well. His body is in Ohio. Tune in next time.